just need to figure out what door this key opens. It has to be somewhere around the temple.
Hey, wait for me!
Oh, you're right. Now that we've got the key, we can open that big door anytime we want. Let's explore. Mimir, you never told us what Magni and Modi had to do with Hrungnir.
Oh, yes. Well, what happened after Hrungnir fell slain upon Thor was that nobody in the court could get the stone body off of him. Thor was no use at this point, his brain rattled, his breath shallow, but none of Odin's men were nearly strong enough to help. Then enter little Magni and Modi, no taller than shrubs, and while nobody but myself was looking, they flipped over Hrungnir's corpse and freed their father. Magni, being blonder, got all the credit. And Modi remained bitter about it from that day to the end, which I don't need to tell you about.
What's that down there?
One, brother.
Yeah! I can't translate this without the whole cipher. Almost. If we could just find the other pieces of the language disk. I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out the differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Oh, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again. Amir, why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cool piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they called us. Knavish spikes to the last. We'd get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. Oh. Then one day he was not amused, and I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads traveled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the paragon of virtue you see before you today.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, I'm coming.
Boy.
It says, glory to Motsignir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break. Very well. To business.
The secret to any craft is in the fine details.
Well, if you don't need it, don't buy it. I always say.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Doesn't fall far.
Enemies. On your mark.
Ah!
the Dwarf King captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
The head is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that. That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh. Well, that's one entry stone.
Prepare yourself!
Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vaedergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Thank you.
few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
This dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Thank you.
Focus up! Look here.
Yes, sir.
Huh. Neat.
Prepare yourself!
Special about it.
There are many legends behind the Tevei Grathika. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes. Your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so.
Yes, sir!
Looks like it needs 3 entry stones. Still won't open? Looks like we need 3.
Strong here. Keep your guard up.
We're in. Okay. Here we go. Down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess. Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Another one here.
Star Cavern. Wow, that's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.